السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له، فاللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، خلق الخلق وأحصاهم عددا، وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردا. من عمل صالحا فلنفسه، ومن أساء فعليها، ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. وأشهد أن سيد الأولين وسيد الآخرين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ رسالة ربه وأدى أمانته، ونصح لهذه الأمة وكشف عنها الغمة، ما ترك شيئا يقربنا من الله والجنة إلا ودلنا عليه، وما ترك شيئا يباعدنا من الله أو يباعدنا من الجنة إلا وحذرنا منه. فصل اللهم وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وذريته ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وارض اللهم عنا معهم أجمعين، اللهم آمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My dear brothers and sisters, روى النعمان ابن بشير رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد، إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الأعضاء بالسهر والحمى، صدق رسول الله. Narrated al-Bukhari wa Muslim radiyallahu anhuma by An-Nu'man ibn Bashir radiyallahu anhuma that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believers, the mu'minin, al-mu'minun, in their mutual kindness, compassion and sympathy are just like one body. If one limb or one of the limbs of this body feels pain or suffers, the whole body, the whole ummah, all the believers will respond to it with wakefulness and fever. صدق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is a hadith, my brothers and sisters, that we all memorize. When رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is teaching us that this ummah, the example of this ummah, the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, is exactly and should be like one body. When any part, any of the limbs of this body suffers, the rest of the ummah, the rest of the body will respond, will take care of it, will help and support. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَعَبُدُونَ. That's why, as Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma in At-Tabarani narrated that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulallah, ayyun nasi ahabbu ila Allah wa ayyul a'mali ahabbu ila Allah. O Prophet of Allah, أي الناس أحب إلى الله؟ Who are those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most? Who are those who are so beloved, are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And also, Ya Rasulallah, what are the deeds, the acts of worship, the ibadat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and likes the most? When you look at the answer of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you can tell about what Islam came to emphasize and highlight and teach everyone from day one, that one main part of our job in this life is, of course, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-haq. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also part of this is to support and help and feel for al-khalq, the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he answered these two main questions by that companion, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أحب الناس إلى الله أنفعهم للناس. The most beloved people to Allah are those who benefit and help and support and care about others and care for them. They are so close to Allah. And he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, gave a list of a'mal and deeds and acts of worship to answer the second question of that companion, and all of them, the whole list of a'mal and acts of worship, all are about people and what we need to do
for those who might need our help. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَأَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Here is the list of a'mal. Or here are some examples, among many examples, of a'mal and work and acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. First, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
سُرُورٌ تُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى مُسْلِمٍ.
Life is full of ups and downs. Hard time, tough time, easy time, subhanAllah, otherwise. Therefore, people are not always happy, not always sad, but when somebody is sad or stressed or depressed, and we do something to bring happiness and a smile back to those type of faces who are stressed. This is number one deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. That's why he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَنْ أَدْخَلَ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ بَيْتٍ مِّنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ سُرُورًا. When you make a Muslim family happy, when you make others happy, لَبْيَرْضَ اللَّهُ لَهُ ثَوَابًا دُونَ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah will guarantee Jannah for that person who intends to make others happy and not otherwise. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَوْ تَكْشِفُ عَنْهُ قُرْبَةً. Hardship. If somebody is going through a hardship and you relieve them, you support them, you do something for those who are in need, children, women, elderly, poor, orphans, sick people. A lot of hardships in life. That's why others who don't have hardships, they should support while others are going through hardships. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَنْ نَفَّسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ. And this is narrated by Abu Huraira. وَمَنْ نَفَّسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا كُرَبُ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ الْعَافِيَةِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make يوم القيامة easy for all of us. اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَوْ تَقْضِي عَنْهُ دَيْنًا. That's another way when you pay people's debts. That's a tough issue that none of us likes to deal with or to face in his or her life. وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَىٰ مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Somebody is in debt, is going through financial hardships or tough time, and people are there to help in that regard. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَوْ تَطْرُدُ عَنْهُ جُوعًا. Look at the word تَطْرُد, to kick away, to push away hunger from those who are hungry or thirsty, are suffering, not finding what to eat or to drink or to wear. This is something that Allah loves also the most. That's why he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that one way to enter Jannah, and not only to enter Jannah, to enter with peace. تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامٍ. One way is to feed others. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, أَفْشُ السَّلَامِ, spread salam. Greet others, spread peace through saying salam to everyone. أَطْعِمُ الطَّعَامِ, feed the food to those, or for those who are hungry and suffering, starving, and take care of your kinship. Pray at night. When you do so, you enter al-Jannah bi salam, peace. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us all to be among those who serve Him with ikhlas and sincerity, to be among those who serve His people and take care of them, and show rahmah, and kindness, and compassion, and sympathy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us Jannatul Firdaus, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. My dear brothers and dear sisters, I started my khutbah today with these two ahadith by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I know we are all aware of this type of ahadith, where Islam teaches us all the time to be united and to be one, like one body, and act and behave like one ummah, and be there for everybody. Because Islam is a rahmah, is all about rahmah, subhanAllah. It is amazing, as one of the ulama said, that when you look at the Quran al-Kareem, first chapter is Surah Al-Fatiha. First verse of Al-Fatiha is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Two names, two sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, both about rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started his kitab, his kalam, his last and final book with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, to show us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his deen, the message of his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is all about rahmah. Allah has many names and attributes, but he chose these two attributes and names, which both about rahmah, to show us that this is mainly how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treats us. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at us. He's ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us his rahmah in dunya and akhirah, ya Rabbil Alameen. I wanted to remind myself and you about these two ahadith and this quality of Islam today. Because everybody is aware of what happened in Palestine, in Gaza. And also, we cannot forget about what happened to our brothers and sisters in Afghanistan. They had an earthquake also this week. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help and support and relief and take care of our beloved brothers and sisters in Palestine, ya Rabbil Alameen. And in Gaza, ya Akram al-Akramin. And in Afghanistan and everywhere, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring his rahmah and peace and tranquility to Muslims everywhere, ya Rabbil Alameen, and to all mankind. Allahumma ameen. I know there is a lot to say, but my advice to myself and my beloved brothers and sisters here at ICSD and in San Diego is that we need to stay focused. We need to stay focused and focus on what we need to do. And I have few advice, few words of advice to myself and my brothers and sisters. I said again, a lot to say, but again, we need to stay focused. And my first advice to myself and my brothers and sisters today is number one, never lose your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never let anything shake your faith or your iman. Always remember and keep in heart and mind that Allah, Rabbul Alameen, is the only one who has the final say on everything in this world at the end of the day. وعلى الله فتوكلوا إن كنتم مؤمنين. Stay certain and put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, never stop making dua for yourself. And all Muslims everywhere, especially in Palestine and in Gaza, and our community here and everywhere in the States, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect again our brothers and sisters in Palestine, ya Rabbil Alameen. And in Afghanistan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us and all human beings from all types of harms. Allahumma ameen. Number three, my brothers and sisters, and this is for me and you, stay calm and stay wise and stay vigilant. Inshallah, nothing happens. But hikmah, wisdom, and staying calm is the key. Never react. Don't be dragged into any nonsense. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows His peace and rahmah to all people, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. And we have to act like Rasulullah. Rasulullah was sent as a rahmah, as mercy. And we have to remember this all the time. Number four, which is very important today. That's why I said we need to stay focused on what needs to be done. What we can do, or one thing that we can do today, is to help and try to help our brother and sister in Palestine and in Gaza. In the legal and right way. And one way to do that is to donate our zakat or our sadaqah to trusted organizations allowed and permitted and certified by the US government to work in places like Palestine and Afghanistan, like Islamic Relief. That's why we have Islamic Relief today. Islamic Relief came today to give us a chance to help our brothers and sisters in Gaza, Palestine. And the question is, which is a question for all of us, how? How Islamic Relief is going to help with this full siege on Gaza and blockade on Gaza? Nothing is entering Gaza at this point, as everybody knows. That's why I said a lot of things to say, but the khutbah is not for this today. Everybody is aware of what has been happening. But let me tell you clearly the situation at this point and as of today. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Islamic Relief has been in Palestine for decades. That's nothing new about that. Islamic Relief has been there, alhamdulillah. And has been having a lot of ongoing projects inside Gaza and in West Bank. But also, to make everything clear and transparent to everybody, that Islamic Relief has been working and delivering aids in Gaza through partners like UNRWA. You know the restrictions, you know the laws, and we have to respect and follow the laws at all times, especially for humanitarian work like this. And we are talking about children, women, elderly, injured people, sick people who need food, water, who need fuel, who need medication. So what happened is that since nothing is entering Gaza at this point, and since Islamic Relief, alhamdulillah, has been having ongoing projects through partners inside Gaza, per and with Islamic Relief permission, all supplies and funds available inside Gaza before this conflict started, all were directed to help with this emergency inside Gaza. Food packages, hygiene kits through UNRWA, and that has been delivered to the people sheltering in UNRWA's schools in Gaza. You know, more than 400,000 people have been displaced in Gaza. And supplies are running out. They will not last. Now, why Islamic Relief is asking for help today? Why? Because Islamic Relief is still working with those partners so that their partners, they will buy supplies from West Bank, store it so that it is ready. Once this siege and blockade is lifted, the supplies and the aids, food, you know, pharmaceutical and medical supplies and fuel will be ready to enter Gaza. We cannot wait till this is over. Allah knows when this is going to be over. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala end this war soon, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make things easy for everybody, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. So we have to be clear that whatever is collected today, zakat or sadaqah, and please do. There is nothing, there is no words to describe the situation. My brothers and sisters, again, and we are doing this legally and clearly and officially through organizations permitted by the government here to work and to help, and Islamic Relief is working in 40 countries. They help 6 million beneficiaries, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, with the help of Allah and the help of our community. Islamic Relief, by the way, to be also very clear, receives aids and help and donations from Muslims and non-Muslims and deliver to everybody, Muslims and non-Muslims, because again, this is the message of Islam, which is again mainly and only about rahmah. May Allah grant us his rahmah, ya Rabbil Alameen. So Islamic Relief is working to get the funds, to work with their partners so that they can buy and store the supplies. And again, we're talking about clearly helping civilians, helping children, women, injured people, sick people who need medical help, who need food and fuel. And that will be bought, inshallah, stored, be ready, inshallah, azza wa jal, through Islamic Relief partners from the West Bank. And then, inshallah, once this war is over, inshallah, once they allow aids and supplies to enter Gaza, it will be ready. Instead of waiting, Allah knows again how long this is going to take. May Allah make it easy, ya Rabbil Alameen, and quick, ya Rabbil Alameen. So please, inshallah ta'ala, after salah, help us to help Islamic Relief, inshallah, do the minimum, which is helping our brothers and sisters, the children and the widows and the orphans, and to at least secure the essential needs like food and fuel and medicine and all that, inshallah ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them, ya Rabbil Alameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us, ya Rabbil Alameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to end this war and conflict as soon as possible, ya Rabbil Alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala alihi wa sahbihi man wala. Few important announcements tonight, inshallah ta'ala, after Isha, there will be a community town hall meeting here at ICSD in the multipurpose room, informing and empowering our community to deal with the current situation. Everybody is invited. Please, parents, please attend, inshallah. Also tonight, youth program at the expansion will have a critical discussion for the youth regarding the situation in Palestine. Only middle and high schoolers are invited. ICSD will have open mosque day next Sunday, inshallah, October 22nd, 2 to 4:30, inshallah. Please invite your non-Muslim friends and bring them to the masjid, inshallah ta'ala. Please be mindful when you park in the neighborhood. This is an issue, my brothers and sisters. We have been having a lot of complaints. And unfortunately, to be very honest with you, some brothers, they really misbehave with the neighbors. I was told that many times. I live in the neighborhood. And one of my very nice neighbors told me yesterday that last Friday, a young Muslim guy with his Mercedes, he insulted me because I was asking him not to park improperly in front of his house. Please, inshallah, help us. And please show them the true Islam and the right Islam, inshallah. Allahumma ameen. So for more information about ICSD programs, please visit icsd.org. Please make dua for some brothers and sisters who passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them rahmah and jannah. I will make dua, inshallah, for our brothers and sisters in Palestine and in Afghanistan and in Gaza especially. Please say ameen. Allahumma ya arhamar rahimeen. Ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Ya hayu ya qayyum. Ya hayu ya qayyum. Ya hayu ya qayyum. Allahumma birahmatika nastaghithu ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma aghith ikhwanana fi Gaza ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma aghith al-atfala wa الشيوخ والنساء والجرحى والمرضى والجوعى والأيتام يا رب العالمين. اللهم استر عوراتهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم آمن روعاتهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ومن خلفهم يا رب العالمين ومن أمامهم. ونعوذ بك يا ربنا أن يغتالوا من تحتهم. اللهم استرهم بسترك الجميل. اللهم كن لهم عونا ونصيرا في هذه الشدة يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لإخواننا في أفغانستان وفي السودان وفي ليبيا وفي المغرب وفي كل مكان وفي سوريا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمهم برحمتك الواسعة. اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احل الأمن والسلام والطمأنينة على المسلمين وعلى كل البشرية في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم اكلأنا بعينك التي لا تنام وركنك الذي لا يضام، واهدنا لما تحب وترضى في أمر الدين والدنيا والآخرة يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم آمين آمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين، فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم، ولا يحض على طعام المسكين، فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون، الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن شاء الله إخواننا. Just a few minutes, inshallah, to help Islamic Relief, inshallah, Taala, through its partners to secure the essential needs like food and fuel and medication. For the people of Gaza once this siege is lifted, inshallah ta'ala. So I would like to start with a brother or a sister or a family here, inshallah, willing to give their zakat or sadaqah, inshallah, one time or monthly, inshallah, to Islamic Relief. And I would like to start with $10,000. If anyone here, inshallah, can give $10,000 to the people of Gaza during this very tough time, please, please raise your hand, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this up for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you Jannah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Qulu Ameen. Ameen, Ya Rabb. Any generous hand, inshallah, any generous hand can start with this amount, inshallah ta'ala, today. Anyone, I know we have been giving to Morocco and to Libya and to all other causes, but subhanallah, this is what happened, and we need to help, inshallah, as much as we can. Any, inshallah, any brother, any sister, inshallah, Allahumma a'ati munfiqan khalafa, $10,000, inshallah, $10,000, $5,000, inshallah. Can I have anyone, inshallah, for $5,000, please? Islamic Relief is outside. We have volunteers around, inshallah. Please, please, do not hesitate. This is the time you show your rahmah, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can show us all his rahmah. Qulu ameen. Ameen, Ya Rab. Any, inshallah, $5,000, inshallah, ta'ala. Anyone? Anyone? Allah yajzi khair, habib. Barakallahu fik. Takbir. Takbir, Allah yirda alayk, jazakallahu khayran wa barakallahu fiik. Any other hand, inshallah? Can I have the second hand, inshallah? Can I have the second hand, please? Sisters, you can join, inshallah. We're talking about women, children, elderly, sick people who need basics. Please, inshallah, so they can survive. May Allah make it.